Hello friends, this video on organisms and their surroundings part 10 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So now that we have understood the concept of habitat and adaptation, it is time that we talk about some of the habitats in more detail. So let us start with desert. So when you think of deserts, some of the key features of a desert are days are very hot and nights are very, very cold. So these adverse climatic conditions during day and night make it very difficult for most of the organisms to live in desert. Less rainfall, and sometimes there is no rainfall for a very long period of time. Dry sandy soil, which do not support growth of most of the plants, because most of the plants need wet soil. And the sandy soil is very dry and it doesn't hold a lot of water. Therefore, the plants do not get a lot of water. Therefore, these dry sandy soil, they do not support growth of plants. So very limited plants are seen in forest. Very limited plants are seen in desert. Now, let us look at some of the plants which are seen in desert. Now, as I said, it is difficult for many plants to adapt to these extreme conditions of deserts. However, deserts have some limited number of plants. Now, there are certain plants like cactus, which are seen in deserts, but they are also adjusted in certain special ways because of which they are able to survive in desert. For example, there is minimum water loss through transpiration. Now, before that, what is transpiration? So in any normal plant, transpiration is the loss of water through the tiny pores on the leaves, which are called stomata. So loss of water through stomata on the leaves. So that is called transpiration. And why transpiration happens in plants? So that the plants can throw out the excess water into the atmosphere. But in case of desert plants, they anyways do not get water. So they do not want to lose any water. So what do? So in these plants, if you look at them, they do not have leaves at all. So the leaves itself are modified. The leaves are modified to structures called spines. Now, since there are no leaves, there are no stomata, and therefore the transpiration is like very minimum. So the water loss is very less. In some plants, in some desert plants, even if you have leaves, the size of the leaves are very small. Now, if the leaf size is very small, the number of stomata on that will also be very less. Therefore, the water loss would also be less. Second thing, water storage in plant parts. Now, in these plants, there are certain parts of the plant which help to store water. For example, the stems. Stems are covered with a thick waxy layer which helps to retain water. Some plants store water in their leaves or roots. So different plant parts help to store water as well, which is not true for the normal plants, because the normal plants anyways have excess water inside them, and that is why they throw that excess water through transpiration. But the scenario is opposite in case of desert plants. So that is why if you look at a desert plant, they look very different from the normal plants. Firstly, because they do not have leaves, instead they have spines. Now these spines, it helps to reduce the water loss, and it also helps to protect the plant from other animals so that the animals do not come and eat them up. The animals will be afraid of the spines because the spines would hurt them. So that way the spines also help in their protection. So spines are one important feature. They help in protection and they also reduce water loss because these are nothing but the modified leaves. Desert plants also have long roots so that these roots can go deep under the ground in search of water, because in the desert areas, the water table is like at a very low level. So if you start digging the water, you will really need to dig very, very deep in order to get the underground water. So that's why these plants have long roots, so that the roots can go deep under the ground and can fetch some water for the plant. Desert animals. Now, the type of animals that we see in desert, they are also, we can say, kind of limited, because these animals also need to be able to survive without food and water for quite some time, because in desert areas, you do not get enough food and water. So these animals, what do to survive in desert? They hibernate during extreme temperatures. What is hibernate? Hibernate is a term given for a long sleep during unfavorable conditions. So the animal goes for a long sleep. So when an organism sleeps for a long time, the need of energy for its body is also less. Have you ever noticed that sometimes when you work really hard, let's say it's your exam time and you are like studying day and night, going to your school, coming back from school, going out to play. So if you are doing a lot of activities in a day, what happens? You tend to get tired. When you get tired, your body needs more energy. So you need more food, you need more water to give that energy to your body. But let's say that you are not doing anything the entire day. You are just lying on your bed and watching TV, or you are just sleeping and you're doing nothing. In that case, you do not feel that much hungry, because your body didn't lose a lot of energy. So the body already has energy. So the same thing is true for these animals. Now these animals, they do not have enough food and water around them. So what do? When the temperatures are extreme, so just to survive, they go for a long sleep. Now when they sleep for several months, the need of energy for their body also gets reduced. So for those several months, they need less water, less food, because they are sleeping all the time. So the body is not really doing a lot of activities. So hibernate is one good option for these desert animals to overcome the unfavorable conditions. Some burrow under the soil. Now during extremely high temperatures, during very high temperatures of the day, some small animals, they burrow under the soil and they stay under the soil. Like snakes, they go deep under the soil and stay there. So at least they get protected, they can escape the heat. Some sleep during the night and some sleep during the day and remain inactive. Now that is also another option, because during daytime the temperatures are very, very high. So some animals, they prefer to sleep during the day and they are not active during the day so that they can escape the heat, but they remain active during the night. So these animals which remain active during the night are called nocturnal animals. So one such example of a nocturnal animal is owl. So it sleeps during the day to prevent dehydration, to prevent any loss of water from its body, and then it remains active during the night. So camels, owls, snakes, these are some of the animals which are commonly found in desert. Now we have already discussed how camels have adapted themselves to live in desert.
Thank you. Please visit www.examfeo.com to watch more educational videos with a better experience. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you once again.